Do you mind if I sit down for a moment?
No.
I'm sorry if I'm bothering you. Couldn't help but notice that there were no flowers beside your bed.
Thank you. It's beautiful.
Okay. Alexander is clean and ready for the world.
What a beautiful little man.
Cheeky. My handsome birthday boy.
Thanks for the cake, Mom.
Mm-hmm. You're welcome. You go get dressed now.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
attention, please, everybody. 11 years ago today, our eldest, Alexander, was born on a glorious summer afternoon. The air was warm and full of possibility. And today, not a single thing has changed. The sun is out, and Alexander is a wonderful boy.
Don't go growing up too fast.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday!
One diamond and one yellow egg.
Nah, maybe two.
One more?
Maybe one more silver.
You can get some of the kaboom.
No.
Okay.
One more.
Maybe a silver.
I told you! You shouldn't eat that kaboom! You should have made one of those!
Hey, listen. Gregori and I, we want to talk to you about something.
Congratulations, sweetheart. We are so happy for you.
Congratulations.
Kids, may I have your attention?
I mean, do we even have room?
We can always make room.
And the boy?
Listen. The minute the nurse left us alone, she looked at me straight in the eye. And she starts to tell me that She always felt like a fish that has been taken off the water and put onto a cutting board. And that she has been left there, jumping up and down, desperately trying to breathe. Like screaming to the world, why don't you just kill me? Well, I guess no. She can relax a little. When her and little Leo feel better, then they'll decide if they want to stay or not.
Next one from Rocky Gate to Foster Street in less than 6 minutes. Go.
Gregori?
Mm.
I haven't put my goals on the board yet.
I know, because you were late. But hey, rules are rules. So, go and stick it up there right now. Maybe you wanted some test answers, right?
Yeah.
They're in my tray.
Gregori?
Yes?
When I cross BD Street, do I go right or left?
You go left.
Exactly.
I'm finished.
How did you go?
Pretty good.
Nineteen right, one wrong. This is what I call a disgrace. So let's go to the bonus question. How would you describe someone who repeatedly disobeys by climbing down the drain pipe instead of using the stairs and ladder that his father built for him?
Forgetful?
Try again.
Sneaky?
It's getting closer. Felix, can you help him?
A savage?
A savage? Well, I guess that's a little harsh. No, I was thinking of the word untrustworthy.
I'm sorry.
Why don't you go put your gold star up there before it sticks permanently to your finger? Go.
Okay. Ready?
Yeah!
Pink. Blue. Red. Blue.
What?
Are you Penelope?
Yes, why?
I have something from your auntie.
Auntie? I don't have an auntie. What is that?
Job, you're making great improvements, you know? How did you feel it went?
Not good.
Oh, come on. Had to be much older than you to have that accuracy, you know?
Okay. The approach went well, and I think the delivery went better this time, but I tripped a bit on the exit.
Oh, that's all right, you recovered well, didn't you?
What?
Sorry, are you Peter Lapado?
Yes. Who are you?
Don't cry and lie and say hello. Oh, hello. Hello.
To be totally honest with you, choosing tonight's pop star wasn't so easy. There's been quite a bit of naughtiness going on this week. I thought you had forgotten that rules are important. And without rules, we will become like them. So, in the end, I decided that since no one person wholly deserves the honor of pop star, tonight, it will be shared. Now, to be fair, Ariana was the closest one to deserving pop star this week. Woo! Beside a minor clothing incident with her mother on Tuesday, she was a star. Spending extra time in the garden, running her errands successfully, Ariana is becoming a dedicated and wonderful role model. Thank you, Ariana. Now, our other pop star is another story. He sometimes likes to lead the way when it comes to naughtiness. But his bounce back this week has been incredibly impressive, and it deserves to be rewarded. He is a very hard-working boy and reminds us every day that he is a star with a heart that beats clearly and powerfully. In fact, for the last 2 months, he has been our leader on the Golden Star board. Thank you for continuing to try, Alexander.
This game of love is done. You're floating like an angel. Come down from up on high. Hold on to me and watch. You'll see the lights descending. A story never ending. A changing of the tide. This trap I laid for you was big enough for two. Sometimes to tell the truth is the hardest thing to do. It's the hardest thing to do.
Hush, I think it's best you hold your tongue. Stars in the ascending, at least until it's light. This trap I laid for you
in different shades of blue
was big enough for two.
Just watch the evening news.
Sometimes to tell the truth,
it's closing in on you.
It's the hardest thing to do.
It's the hardest thing to do.
It's the hardest thing to do. Now every time we walk, hold my hand,
yeah, every time we walk,
just hold my hand,
sorry to pull you away from all the fun out there. I just couldn't go to bed without settling this little mystery. Do you know what these are?
Found them outside. The crown. I just like them.
Yeah, well, it's a funny little thing, isn't it? I love how curious you're becoming. But that's the tricky thing out there. Sometimes things do look good. When I was a boy, just like you, all I had to remember my mother by was her bottle of perfume. After she died, it was my favorite thing to play with. I would always pretend it was something different. A cowboy, a soldier, a doctor. Well, one day, I learned something new about that perfume. It's that when you use it with a box of matches, it can create a vicious and unforgiving fire. I remembered the feeling so clearly. I stood there, totally confused, watching my arm on fire, wondering how something that smelled so good could suddenly cause me so much pain. I remember I could hear sirens. They were getting closer and closer. And you know what hurt the most about having my arm on fire? Is that I knew that those sirens were not coming for me. And that's the way of the world. That's the danger of it. But hey, here, you don't have to worry about those things. You know, if you want anything, you just ask me and we'll get it. Right?
Yeah.
When was the last time I told you I love you? Because you know how much I do, right?
I love you too.
It's so important to cherish the things you love while you have them and to protect them. Your beautiful mother and your brother or sister that she carries around everywhere with her. You'll have to look after them. Be the older brother, their protector, and destroy anyone who tries to do them wrong. Right?
Yeah.
Right?
Of course.
It's beautiful, Leo.
You must really like that, sweetie. How are you feeling?
I'm fine, really. I've been sleeping a lot. Gregori has been saying it's important to listen to my body. So I have been, and he's telling me to sleep. But every time I go to sleep, I keep on having such a strange dream. I can't remember that happening with Alexander. I'm standing next to a beautiful hill. It's covered in thick green grass and lots of poppies. When I look up it, it looks infinite, like the hill goes on forever into the sky. And then all I do is walk down it.
Why don't you just walk up the hill?
I don't know. I just walk down.
Yes, it's easier that way.
Yeah, I guess that's true. It is easier.
One of the greatest pleasures of winter gardening is having time to plan. The garden is in its most raw state, so it's a perfect time for rethinking things. As autumn fades, taking its rich colors and abundance of produce with it, it leaves behind a garden stripped bare.
That's not accurate.
What did you say, Leo?
That's not accurate. Your garden isn't stripped bare.
I'm sorry, I don't think I understand.
Root vegetables and Brussels sprouts can be harvested in winter. So can rhubarb, broccoli, beetroot, peas.
Well, yes, Leo, you're right, absolutely. Absolutely. But as a matter of fact, as you can see, we are growing all those things here. And I was just delivering the general facts of winter gardening for everybody else and had not yet gone into the specifics of our own little winter garden.
You're not growing peas.
He's right. We don't have any.
We have sugar snap peas, okay? Can we continue now, please? All right.
Sugar snap peas are a mutant pea.
You know what? I think that's enough talking. Now, let's start doing. All right? So everybody, back to your digging. Back to your digging. Alexander, over there. Over there. Let Leo work on his own little dirt project.
Green is your favorite color? Hmm? Well, we're gonna put it up there with everyone else. As soon as Andre is finished with your hook. Hmm? And then maybe one day you will get your own brand new backpack. How did that sound?
I don't like wearing backpacks.
Well then, what do you like to wear?
Danger feathers.
Danger feathers? You like to wear danger feathers? And what are they?
You're grown up. You don't know what danger feathers are.
Uncle Charlie! Uncle Charlie! Uncle Charlie! little professor.
Look at you, figures of ox. Hello, hello. Little princess, look how you've grown.
Oh.
You were dying.
Hey, I'm gonna need more jewels.
Felix! You charmer. What do you need?
Bracelet, earrings,
Okay.
Definitely gold. Maybe a brooch?
Uh-huh.
So, what are we looking at this month?
Well, it's a little slow.
Yeah.
They're all simple, but only three.
Three?
Three.
Oh, come on, Charlie, what am I supposed to do? Kids aren't cheap, you know.
No, they're not cheap. Look, this is good. Simple.
All right. What about you? How are you?
Surviving.
David, 1 error and 50 points. Nicholas, none. Alexander, 5 errands and 250 coins.
Children, the light of this world.
Sleep first.
Okay.
Mom, I already gotta go now. Come on.
You know the rule. Listen, I'm really almost done. You are getting your goodbye hug.
Oh! Oh!
No.
Why? It's all right. No, it's not. Sorry, it took me on time. Babies make women a little bit crazy. I'm fine. Keep going. You'll be late.
Lucille!
How much?
Meatballs.
Say the man.
How much?
8:30.
8:30, sir. Your fingers are as slippery as my floor. For being a good son to your mother. I'm guessing that means is not for you.
Hey.
Hey.
How did you go?
Mm-mm.
No show?
Yeah.
You didn't stop anywhere?
No.
Come, go get changed, quick.
You done? Why did you do that? I didn't ask you to do that.
You were sad. You grab his legs and flip him upside down.
Upside down?
Don't worry, this is causing no pain. See, it actually has a hypnotic effect on him and calms him down instantly.
Now, in this state, he's a well-behaved boy.
Crazy. Came out of nowhere. It was a fight, but she can't get near him.
Sweetheart. Come on, sweetie. It's okay. It's
okay. Come on, Leo. Leo? Leo? I'm coming in. Think it's a little dangerous?
You'll make them extinct.
Extinct? Extinct, but nobody wants to make them extinct. They're just living the life of a chicken, Leo. Just like you are living the life of a boy. Those chickens are gonna die, and eventually we'll eat them for our dinner.
Leo!
That's what you want. Nobody is allowed to speak or communicate with Leo. He is to be left alone with his chickens and his violence.
Chickens have a funny life.
What's funny?
Aren't they just born to die?
Oh, baby. We all are. It's what you do before then that matters.
How do I do something before then?
Well, you don't have a choice. You just will. I promise. Okay, I got it. It's a giraffe.
No.
You're a master of suspense.
Okay. I guess you can look now.
Oh. Sweetie, it's beautiful.
That's you? That's my baby brother? And I'm waiting down there so that no one gets you. Are you okay?
Alexander?
Yeah?
Could you please look after the chickens for me while I'm gone?
Where are you going?
Searching for scarlet danger feathers.
When?
Tomorrow morning.
Gregori found a whole collection of them under a tree. We're going to investigate them.
She said we won't be long.
Okay, sure. I'll look after the chickens. Hey, why'd you like chickens so much?
Because chickens are the closest living relative to the Tyrannosaurus Rex. I won't let them become extinct, too.
Okay, I already gotta go back now.
Alexander, baby, we need to get up.
Come on.
We need to get downstairs quickly.
Thank you. I know it's a little bit earlier than what we would have liked, but we haven't had a chance yet to talk about what happened yesterday with Leo. But personally, I was left pretty mixed up inside. I know that most of you have never seen that kind of anger and aggression, and I'm really sorry you had to. And it's certainly been a long time since I've been around that kind of behavior. And last night, I couldn't stop thinking about it. I was laying there in my bed, trying to figure out how I could help little Leo to feel better. to avoid any repeat incidents. When suddenly I realized that all the hypotheticals and what-ifs running through my head were useless. The best person to talk it through with would be Leo. So in the middle of the night, I went down to the pin. And there he was, shivering like a frozen mouse. He was so cold. And I pleaded with him to get out of there so we can chat about everything inside where it's warm, you know? He refused. He had this mad look in his eye and he said there was no way he would get out of this pin, then or ever. I mean, it was obvious that he couldn't think clearly. So as hard as it was to leave him there, I realized that I had no choice. And this morning when Rosa went to check on him, he was gone. Well, now everyone, let's not forget that these are the acts of a boy with a troubled brain.
Rosa has gone out there looking for him. All we can do is wait and hope that he decides to come back. Your mothers are gonna check the tunnel. Let's hope he just got himself lost out there.
Come on. Dig into the chicken, Alexander. A growing boy like you needs to stock up on his protein, you know? It's really, really good. Your mother roasted to perfection. Susanna, please. Can you put some chicken on Alexander's plate?
Please, sweetie, eat the chicken. Just try a little bit.
Can you eat the damn chicken, please? Come on, eat it.
Please, baby, try some for me.
Come on, eat it.
Gregori, maybe we give him a break.
Eat it. Go to your room. Go to your room.
His name is Tobias. He was born very early this morning.
Come. Come meet your baby brother.
Hi, Tobias.
Then when he's finished, we burp him and he sleeps again.
He never needs to think or do anything for himself.
Not yet. You know he can feel everything. Babies can sense energy we don't even notice. That's why it's so important not to have any negative energy or people around him.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
What kind of energy do I have?
Let me have a look. Yep. Definitely the good kind. Tobias and I would follow you anywhere.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. Now we burp him. Now you try. You're natural.
Mom?
Hmm?
Does Gregori lie sometimes?
What?
That night, when Leo was with the chicken.
Alexander, enough. You know I don't want to talk about them. They've left. They're not a part of our lives anymore.
Mom, I think Gregori lies.
You're doing really well. Keep going while I get a towel.
Strong grip. That's good. No one will get you if you're strong. Don't worry. I'll teach you all the important things like that. This is my job. I'm your protector.
Morning, sleepy. Happy birthday.
Thank you, Mom. Thank you, Tobias.
So Gregory said to head straight down after breakfast.
Okay.
Why aren't you wearing your necklace anymore?
I'm stupid.
You like it? No more itchy kisses. So, getting old, Mr. Alexander. Got your pistol? Sometimes I just worry that I shelter all you kids too much. It was our decision, though, to do everything we could to prevent you from the ugliness of what the world had to offer. We felt that we could provide a better life for you kids than the one we had. One where you can fight back, relax, enjoy our time together.
But you didn't like it when Leo fought back.
I see. I'm not going to talk about them. It's just too upsetting for me. If you don't want to eat chicken for the rest of your life because of that, that's fine with me. I understand. But on the other hand, Leo is a troubled little boy.
What was he fighting for? Nothing. You want something worth fighting for? Why don't you go upstairs and ask Sylvia how she got that giant scar on her thigh? Or ask Sophia why she will never, ever travel by train again? Or go and ask Penelope what happened to her young brother right in front of the house? Listen. I'm glad that you didn't have to go through all those things like your mother and I did. Because here it's all good. You're safe. What would you rather? Be hit by a man or hit a man first?
Hit a man first.
So would I.
Hey, can I help you?
Are you Carl Tillman?
Yeah? Who are you?
Alexander.
Alexander? What's up, Alexander?
Do you have any aunties?
Yeah, I have an auntie. So what's going on?
I've got something for you from your auntie.
Sorry, I don't understand.
Thank you. Is there blood?
Yeah.
Well, you don't have to cry like a girl about it. Cool. That looks so real. Where the hell did you get this?
On the chest like that, yes. And when you did that, you go for the double foot massage. Yes, you grab those strong little pads we have here. Aren't they? It's good. What happened? You okay? I'm gonna get some bandages. Ruben, take care of Tobias, okay? Take care.
What happened? Okay. Where are you going?
Alexander, where are you? Alexander, you're okay?
I brought bandages for your knees, but you were gone. So what happened? Something went wrong? Okay. Pass me Tobias. I'm gonna take care of your knees. So what do you want to do on your birthday?
Whatever I want.
Okay.
I want to do whatever I want tomorrow too.
sure I made a few mistakes. Everybody does. But you're gonna grow up. And you'll remember me and everything I taught you. And you'll regret what you're thinking right now. And you'll think back. And you'll say, Gregori was right. He was right. Now, come on. Pass me Tobias. It's a bit cold for him down here, please.
He's sensitive to bad energy.
To bad energy?
Alexander!
Bad energy? Hey. You might think you know about life, about what's good and what's bad, but you don't. You're just a child. A little child. The only reason you know how to hold that gun is because I taught you how.